In this video, I'm going to show you how to use PowerShell so you can get a status report for your SCCM software update deployments. And we're starting right now. Hey, what's up, guys? Paul from the Sysadmin Channel bringing you the best tips and tools for your sysadmin journey. In this channel, we cover a lot of sysadmin how-tos and tutorials, as well as troubleshooting tips and tricks. So if you're new, consider subscribing. So a couple of videos back, we went over how to install software updates using SCCM. And it occurred to me that there's no easy way to export or programmatically view the status of the machines. So for example, let's say I wanted to get a status of all of the machines that failed for a certain deployment group. And then I wanted to export that list and send it to one of the desktop support guys so they can troubleshoot or look into it a little further. Currently, as of right now, I do not know a way to do that. So if you do, go ahead and leave a comment down below and let me know. By the way, guys, all of the stuff shown in this video can be learned from several books. Two of my favorite books are Learn PowerShell in a Month of Lunches, as well as SCCM Unleashed. If you want to expand your PowerShell and SCCM knowledge, go ahead and grab yourself a copy and I'll leave the links in the description. All right, so moving on with the video, the next thing we're gonna wanna do is go into Google and we're gonna type in get SCCM update status, sysadmin channel. And the reason we're doing that is so we can go to the sysadmin channel page so we can copy the script that we're gonna use. So right here, I've highlighted the page that you're going to click on. So we'll click on that. And it's gonna bring us to the sysadmin page with the script. And the page is titled get SCCM software update status using PowerShell. So there are a couple of requirements for using this script. If you are going to be using the deployment ID from GUI parameter, then you will need to have the SCCM configuration module installed on your computer. Otherwise, everything uses WMI to get the data that you need. So as far as parameters go, there's only three and I'll go over them right now. So the first one is going to be deployment ID from GUI. And what this basically does is a pop-up will show up with all of the assignment IDs and all of the deployments that you've currently have. And all you simply need to do is just click on the deployment and then click OK. Once you click OK, all of the statuses will show up on the PowerShell window. All right, the next parameter is the deployment ID. And this parameter allows you to enter in a deployment ID manually. And in order to get that deployment ID, you would right-click on the column label or the column header and then select assignment ID. So this is basically the same thing as the deployment ID from the GUI, except that you don't need the SCCM module installed, and you can choose the deployment ID manually from whatever list you want. So now moving on to the third and final parameter. This is the status parameter. This allows you to filter by status. So currently there are only four statuses. There is success, in progress, error, and unknown. And if you look in the SCCM console, you would see the same structure in the monitoring tabs. All right, so now that we got those parameters out of the way, let's go ahead and copy the actual script. So here I'm just gonna highlight everything, right click copy, and then I'll open up Windows Explorer and then we're gonna create a new document. So I'll go ahead and close Chrome, launch Windows Explorer, and here I'm gonna right click new and then create a text document. We're gonna call this text document get SCCM software update status.ps1. We'll go ahead and select yes to the naming and then we'll open it up using PowerShell ISE and then simply paste the contents of the script. We already went over what it does, so there is only one thing that you will need to change, and that would be the SCCM site code and the site server. So I have my site code is pack and my site server is pack-SCCM. So once you got that done, go ahead and save it and then go ahead and close it. We're not gonna need this anymore. We'll go ahead and close Windows Explorer as well. And now we can see that we are in our SCCM console. So like I said before, we can right click on the column header and then select assignment ID. And that will give us all of the deployment IDs that we're looking for to use the deployment ID parameter. So like I said, if we click on one of them, we can see the status of each machine, and that is sorted by the compliant tab. We can see the start time. We can see the in-progress machines, so we can see that those are pending reboots. The script will only show those that are in progress, so it won't give any further detail. I also don't have any errors or any unknowns. So the next thing we're going to do is open up a PowerShell window, and we're going to want to dot source the function. So in my case, I have the script located in a C scripts folder, and in order to dot source it, we need to type in dot space dot and then the path to where the script lies. So that's the first thing. The second thing is something I actually forgot to mention earlier, is that you actually need a deployment ID in order for it to run successfully. So here, if we just type in the name, or if we're just calling the function, it throws out an error saying a deployment ID was not specified. So if we run the deployment ID from GUI, we can see here that it will pop up with a pop-up. And we can expand this assignment name. So the assignment names are the deployment names that you set for it. And we can see we'll choose Windows updates for servers 2018-8. And in this case, that assignment ID is 1677233. So if we just highlight that, click OK, it would show us the status as if we were looking in the GUI, in the monitoring tab. So it also shows with the deployment name, with the deployment ID, the device names, the collection, the status times, and the status itself. So if we wanted to run the status, or if we wanted to run a deployment ID using the manual method, we'll go ahead and copy this deployment ID shown here. You will see that it gives us the exact same results. So as I mentioned earlier, there is a status parameter. So if we wanted to see a deployment update status for a certain, let's say we wanted to only view in progress machines, we can type in tag status and in progress, and it'll filter out everything that is in progress. We can also use regular PowerShell expressions here. So if we wanted to sort, or if we wanted to filter by everything that was not successful, then we can do a where object status not equal success, and it'll show us everything that is not successful. So we can see here that it outputted the same information. Since I only have in progress, that it outputted in progress. The deployment name, the deployment ID is all the same. So at this point, you might be asking yourself, Paul, like, what the hell? Why do you need to run a script, an overly complicated script, to just get the status of machines when you can easily view that in the monitoring tab in SCCM, in the SCCM console? Well, for one, because PowerShell, bro. I'm a huge fan of PowerShell, and I love creating scripts for sometimes nonsense. It helps me learn, and it just gets me in the mood. What the fuck? And two, it's because it allows you to create custom objects for anything that you want. So in this case, I've created custom objects for the devices, for the device name. So I'll go ahead and highlight that. And let's say we wanted to do something crazy. So we'll open up another PowerShell window. And if we wanted to, we can run, I have a restart sync cycle script that I created also, or actually I found somewhere. But if we wanted to run that, we can basically do a resync of all of the devices all at once. So I'll go ahead and call that function just so I can show you guys. So in this case, I'll type in start-sccm sync cycle, and we'll highlight those computer names. And since the computer name is in my clipboard, we'll put that in parentheses. And we can see here that it will automatically output or run against those objects in the clipboard. So that's one way. Another reason is if you're feeling a little devilish or a little crazy, you can do something like a for each loop and iterate a command to all of the computers in that clipboard or in an array. So in my case, we'll do for each computer in the computers in the clipboard. And if you wanted to restart, we can also do an iteration of the restart. So that's another way. I don't recommend restarting your servers unless you want to get fired or written up or something. But hey, you know, PowerShell is very dynamic and it allows you to do a lot of things. So that about wraps it up for today's video. If you have any questions, go ahead and leave them down in the comment sections. If you like this video, go ahead and smash that like button. And if you did not, let me know why in the comment section as well. Until next time, this is Paul with the Sysadmin Channel, signing out.